talk that boxing. This is Mr. A giving you a breakdown and prediction on the IBF lightweight championships fight between Robert Easter Jr. and the challenger Denis Shabanov going down on June 30th, PBC on Bounce TV. Let's get into this breakdown. But first, please subscribe, share these videos, like them, thumbs up, leave comments. I got 16 subscribers. Let's push that up to 50. Can we? Help me out. Thank you guys. Now this breakdown and prediction. Let me chill out. I'm about to go home and grill some bacon dogs. But first, we're gonna get into this breakdown. Denis Shabanov got a huge hill to climb, like the hill I'm sitting on right now. But even taller, I should say. He has a 6-inch reach disadvantage and a 7-inch on the height, or vice versa. So Denis is gonna have to make this a phone booth fight and stay a busy motor. He can't afford to take a round off. So in doing so, he's gonna have to take the least amount of punishment working his way in. He cannot afford to just bull rush in and get picked off. He has to come in with some head feints, body feints, coming at angles, work himself in with a jab, a triple jab, and then once he gets in, beat the whole body of Robert Easter Jr. Beat him down, try and wear Robert Easter out, try and take as much gas out of that tank as you can, beat the body down for just numerous 4 or 5 rounds in the beginning. I wouldn't even try and go for the head unless it's completely open. Now when he does go for a headhunter, he has to make sure he's either gonna be first or he has to throw with Robert Easter Jr. Because Robert Easter Jr., for some odd reason, with the height advantage he always brings in, he loves fighting in a phone booth fight, and you can counter him inside and he gets hit a lot. But the Richard Comey fight, he took hellacious hits, but both those guys showed they had chins. So Denis Shabanov, be prepared for Robert Easter to take some of your hits, but keep delivering those power shots to the head. Throw with him and work that body. And when you do escape, when you need a break, you gotta escape on an angle. Do not back straight out. And watch out when you are inside. Watch out for that step back uppercut, because Denis is gonna be in there so much, he's gonna be leaning forward. It's gonna be an open check hook season and open step back uppercuts. He's gonna have to watch out for that. Now for, one more thing for Denis, he has to either commit all the way inside or commit all the way on the outside of the reach. So that way you're only taking breaks, be an inch and a half outside of his 7-inch reach. You know, circle around the ring and get your breath back. Now, as for Robert Easter Jr., keep your distance, man. Let this just be a jab fight. Denis is gonna come in, make it a phone booth fight. You're gonna have to stay patient. Show adaption to your game. Stay patient, use ring generalship, like a Lennox Lewis. Let this just be a jab fest. You should win this fight on nothing but your jab and maybe a step back check uppercut. And occasionally a check hook when he comes to rush in, Denis that is. This should be one of the easier showcases for Robert Easter Jr. with this height and reach advantage. He has a guy coming dead at him in a straight line. This should be a very easy fight. That's the breakdown, and my prediction is a unanimous decision, and still champion, Robert Easter Jr., right here on Ready Ready Talk That Boxing with Mr. A, RRT Boxing. Please subscribe, and remember, take my 16 subscribers up to 50. I will appreciate that. Thank you guys for all your support. You see what I do, I show the effort, I put the love in, I try and research all these fights for us. RRT Boxing, baby. Mr. A is out. Enjoy your day, enjoy that boxing like I will.